निकलेगा. सो वो आहुति जो है वो क्रिटिकल पॉइंट है. वी नीड टू कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट, देन म्यूचुअल रिस्पेक्ट एंड एप्रिसिएशन. द मोमेंट यू से ही इज अ स्वीपर, इसको क्या पता है, ही इज नॉट अ स्वीपर, ही इज अ हाइजीन वर्कर. ही कैन हिज लैक ऑफ कंसर्न और हिज मिस्टेक कैन टोटली डिमोलिश द सर्जरी दैट ए सर्जन डज, राइट. एंड नो हाइजीन वर्कर वॉन्ट्स हिम टू बी इक्वेटेड विद द मालिक, बट ही जस्ट वॉन्ट्स दैट ही इज एप्रिशिएटेड फॉर द रोल दैट ही इज प्लेइंग, राइट. बिल्ड इंटरलिंकेजेस. वी हैव अ हैबिट, द मोमेंट्स वी फॉल इल इमीजिएटली वील पिक अप द फोन, टॉक टू आर फ्रेंड्स दैट हु इज द बेस्ट डॉक्टर इन टाउन एंड लेट अस गो एंड कंसल्ट द डॉक्टर, राइट. आई विल जस्ट शो यू वॉट इज द प्रॉब्लम दैट इट क्रिएट्स. देन देर इज ए रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट विच इज ए जेन्युइन थिंग. देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम इन रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट, बट द डेंजर कम्स वेन इट बिकम्स ERROI. एंड वॉट इज ERROI? Exorbitant return on investment. So the real problem is in that understanding. We want to be rich overnight, right? We want to have the entire world overnight, and this has come from Hindi films. Now, in the beginning, you will show a person in rags, fatehal, ghoom raha hai bilkul, and then suddenly he has a 16-bedroom bungalow, 5 Mercedes, and a purse full of notes. And it is never shown how it comes.
Is there no restriction on the charge by
the is there a restriction on the hotels that you go to?
You have a 5-star, 3-star, right?
Yes.
But on a physician, it's a common thing.
No, how can it be common?
Physician.
No, that's what I'm saying. A physician who is sitting on Flora Fountain or Church Gate or Kulaba, versus somebody who is in Goregaon, the entire cost structure itself will be different. No, that is only one of the factors. Then it depends upon the seniority. Even if you are serving, your starting salary, and by the time you have grown up, there is a lot of salary difference with the same person. That's what I am saying. Even within the same area, if there is a difference between the seniority, and then it can be also my own perception about the value of service which I am offering, right? So that is a choice. Like when we were doing the first meeting, there was a discussion of this same kind what you are referring to. So a friend of mine said that you have a choice whether you go to a 5-star hotel or a dhaba. But what you want to ensure is that you should not get gastroenteritis even when you go to a dhaba.
No, but here one of the five-star hotels, they have a menu card. You know that here they have a lot of hidden costs and hidden fees. That only it will come in day to day after the operation, after the surgery.
Yes. I agree with you. That is. No, qualified is one thing. What about their experience? Yes, so that is perception, no?
Better doctor than the doctor next door, who's charging less.
Sir, I have this problem all the time when I go to 5-star hotels. When they'll come and say, sir, mineral water or regular water. I said, what do you mean by regular water? 5-star hotel, if you can't guarantee safe water, then what is the safety of rest of the things? And this mineral water is basically drinking water, and if you see the bottles being filled, you'll probably never take it again. It's mainly plastic industry. The amount of pollution that we are creating, the amount of waste which we are creating is unimaginable.
I think a lot of people are not aware that the kind of water which they are drinking, and then they recycle that water, they take it home, fill it up, and they don't understand that they've got a lot of gases, natural
carbon, which comes to health. Apart from all those things, what I am saying is a direct. You see, there is a very interesting presentation also. The entire amount of water, the bottles that are consumed in 1 year throughout the world, will be sufficient to ensure safe drinking water for all times to come to the entire population. And despite that, nobody does. That is what I'm constantly cringing about. We know it. Despite that, we don't do it. That is the problem. It's like everybody knows that it is good to speak the truth. Despite that, how many speak the truth? That is the question. Now, why, what has changed actually and why it was so? In the past, when the infectious diseases were the commonest, from a bad throat, you come to me for treatment. I look at you, I give you a prescription and just tell you take it for 5 days. I know that you'll get all right in 2-3 days and after that you'll stop the medicine. You'll not even come back again. Right? In all likelihood you'll get all right. So once you've got all right, then you also forget and the whole matter ends. Right? This is what was happening so far. Episodic care. Right? Now because of this episodic care, the level of interaction between the providers and care receivers was minimal. There was no need for that interaction. I have seen your throat, putting a torch. I know it is pharyngitis. I have given you a prescription. You'll take the medicine. In whatever way, you'll get all right. And the whole thing will be finished. Now what is happening is, illness is coming in, proportion of continuous increasing, and that is it is ruled by the episodic communication. See, the thing is that it can happen. There is a very interesting study. They did a worldwide study on perceptions about doctors. So it came out that doctors are arrogant. But my doctor is a saint. What it means is that the general perception is that doctors are arrogant. But when I talk to him, then I find him a very helpful person. On an individual basis. Sorry? Not only because of that. You see, the thing is, there is always a perception. There is always a perception. You see, we all have a perception, all politicians are bad. But it's not true. Not all of them are like that. Similarly, it can be for engineers. It can be, for example, civil engineers have always had a very bad reputation. In the sense of corruption or taking money and things like that. But it's not that we have such beautiful civil structures. They could not have come just like that. Today if we think the upper Ganga Nehar which was made and the time that it was made is a record even today. That could not have happened without a band of dedicated people. Anyway, as I was saying, why it is important that you should not go to a super specialist or look in town, because the need-based care proportions are the primary care is the largest, then is the secondary, and then only is the tertiary. Right? Tertiary is the super specialist care, secondary is where you require specialist care, and primary is the... Right? On the other hand, when you look at this, from the resource base per patient, tertiary is far more expensive. Right? Then primary. So if you are going to Dholakia for a pain in the little finger, then naturally it is going to be prohibitively expensive. Tatas can afford to fly an orthopedic surgeon from your company account for which you are paying actually. Right? Because expenses will be taken off as taxes. Right?
I would like to just add something.
Yes.
Even if it comes to a condition like eye, certainly I would not like to go bypass my GP. At the most, I might ask him to read the book of the
law. Go on. If you have finished, answer.
This is why. And when it comes to time, I don't think a mother will take a chance with the GP.
That's precisely what I am trying to say. This is the fundamental problem. See, the thing is that doctor whom you are saying as GP, do you think he's not trained for all this?
He's trained.
Yes.
But what happened? The type of training he has for 3 months is something good. Like a
again a problem of perception which is actually created by the society, which government is a part of it also. You see, there are many conditions of the eye like conjunctivitis, eye flu. Those things do not require a specialist treatment. You see, you are sitting in Mumbai, so you have access where you can do it. What happens in the periphery where you don't have a doctor itself, leave aside a specialist or anything, then what do you do? What I am suggesting, what I am saying is that, you see, there was a concept of in olden days of your family physician or your family doctor.
Because of this attitude only now they are reducing.
Yes, because of this attitude, now that family doctor knew even your genes. Right? And his diagnosis and his treatment would be far more beneficial. Because he knows the allergies, the kind of environment that exists in that family, the reasons of that illness, he would take all those factors into consideration, which will not happen in an impersonal interaction with the you are saying there's a problem, that's a possible problem from one point of view when we use our Indian mentality. That is, you go to the bank and you meet the peon there and you ask him, who is the manager? He says, manager se kya kaam hai, mere ko batao na, main aapko batata hoon. So he'll behave as if he is the chairman and managing director as well. So whatever he says is final, but there is no further thing which is required beyond that. Whereas I was in UK and I was staying with my cousin actually. He was just going through his cupboard and he discovered a coat which he had purchased from Marks and Spencer about 2-3 years ago, and he never wore it because it never fitted him. So it just kept on hanging in the wardrobe and he kept on thinking that I'll go and change it. So since I was there and we had to go around shopping, etc., they said, ki chal yaar, ye coat bhi haath ke haath badalwa lete hain. So we went to the Marks and Spencer store and we said that this coat does not fit, ye aap wapas kar liye. So So the sales girl, she saw the coat, she looked something inside and she said, sir, when did you buy it? I said, I don't, we have the cash memo. She said, I don't keep the, I haven't kept the cash memo, I don't know. It is from Marks and Spencer. She said, yes, it is from Marks and Spencer. Can you please wait for a few moments? So then she called her supervisor. The supervisor came. Yeah, sir, when did you purchase this coat from? Where did you purchase this coat? Sir, what is all this nonsense?